Are the Camlin Artist Acrylic Paints worth a try? Hi, this is Madhula, the artist behind Madhula Creations, helping you to learn to draw, paint and relax through art. Camlin is one of the well-known as well as easily available product here. So let's go over to do a review on their artist acrylic paints. Let's get started. Camlin Artist Acrylic Colors come in different sizes and sets. It starts from 9 ml 12 shades pack. It has 12 shades of 9 ml tubes. This is a 20 ml 12 shades pack. This also comes in a 20 ml 18 shades pack. 40 ml individual tubes, and this is a 120 ml individual tubes. So you have the option to choose individual colors too. Apart from this box, I also want to show you the special colors, that is the metallic colors that you can get as individual tubes. I will show you some of them. So you get these metallic shades in both 40 ml and 120 ml tubes. First, I will show you the consistency of the Camlin Artist acrylic paints directly from the tube. I will just choose three random colors. Here we go. As you can see, they are actually soft and creamy. Now we will see how these paints actually work. Let's do a swatch test on the colors. I'll do it with the 9 ml 12 shades pack so that you know the exact colors available on this pack. Okay, and I'm doing it on canvas so we can see how these colors look on the canvas too. Starting from Viridian Green, Sap Green, Cobalt Blue Hue, Prussian Blue, Crimson Lake, Scarlet Red, Permanent Yellow Deep. This is an interesting color in this set. Okay, let's move on. Yellow Ochre, Lemon Yellow, Burnt Sienna, Black and White. So these are the colors from the 12 shades pack set. You'll get the same set of colors in the 20 ml set as well. The colors are really nice and vibrant. I did a comparison between the Camlin Artist acrylic paint and the Fabrica acrylic colors, which comes in bottles. Do check that out too. I'll just link it on the card above and the description box below. Now let's move on to coverage. I have not applied any gesso to the canvas so that we can clearly see how it covers the canvas. I am using Scarlet Lake Sap Green. Canvas coverage is really good. There are no white spots of the canvas showing through. Let me show you closely. Now we will blend two colors, Scarlet Lake and Yellow. My concentration here is to get a new color in the middle. Okay, there we go. Here we will do a Crimson Lake and a Cobalt Blue Hue. Okay, here we got a Dark Violet. Nice blending capabilities actually. Let's now try blending three different colors. Burnt Sienna, Permanent Yellow Deep, which is more to an orange end, and then Lemon Yellow. Here my concentration will be to bring out a smooth transition. This is very nice. We really can get a smooth transition out of these paints. Now let's see if these paints are okay for textural effects. Let's see if it can hold peaks and layers and if they are suitable for using with palette knives. I'm going to use this palette knife to spread the paint on the canvas. We will create heavy peaks here. I will show it closely. Okay. Now here we will create mild peaks. Now I will allow it to dry and let's see what happens. Apart from this box, I also want to show you the special colors, that is the metallic colors that you can get as individual tubes. I will show you some of them. Antique gold, gold bronze, antique bronze, and then silver. The metallic colors are really glossy. I will show you in close up. It also has a very nice coverage. Now that the peaks are dry, the paint actually holds the peak well. If you really want a very heavy peak, you can mix them with a texture paste as well. So this is how it looks after it dries. Okay, so here are the four sizes in tubes: 9 ml, 20 ml, 40 ml, and 120 ml. 9 ml, 20 ml, and 40 ml are available as sets. 40 ml and 120 ml are available as individual tubes. Apart from this, you also get these shades in 500 ml jars. So if you want to paint in a massive scale, you can pick them too. Totally, as of now, there are around 60 shades of the colors to choose from. If you are a beginner, go with the 20 ml 12 shades pack, and then you can add on your colors from 40 ml or 120 ml tubes. So whatever colors you are using the most will be over soon, right? Then go ahead to pick either the 40 ml or 120 ml tubes according to the size of the canvas you wanted to work on. I specifically say to pick up the 20 ml tube set for a reason, which I'll tell you why in a couple of minutes. So first, let's decode what's on the tube now. I also have another video that talks about all the materials you need to start your acrylic painting and how to start acrylic painting for less than 1,000 rupees. You can watch that from the card above, and I'll also link it in the description box below. Let's see what's on the tube now. At the top it says Camel Artist's acrylic color and the size of the tube. This is a 120 ml tube. Then comes the paint info. This piece of information on the artist paint tubes are very vital, which you would not find in the hobby range of colors. They convey very important information about the paint. The number here is the color code of the paint. So each of the colors have a particular number for identification. Then you have the exact paint name. This alphabet here denotes the permanency of the color, that is how light fast the color is. A indicates absolutely permanent, B indicates permanent, and C indicates fairly permanent. Most of the Camel Artist paint tubes are in the range of A and B, so you need not worry much if they will be permanent enough. Even if it's C rating, the color is going to be permanent when used as is from the tube without any dilution with water. Or you could also use mediums to dilute instead of water. That will solve the problem. Then we have series number 1, 2, 3. This indicates the price group for the paint tube. So this directly relates to the price on the tube. Series 1, as you can see, cost 220 rupees. So all the tubes marked with series 1 will cost the same amount at that particular time of packaging or purchasing. Then you have series 2, which costs 240 rupees. Series 3 costs 300 rupees. Even though the series number directly indicates the price, the actual price difference might be due to various reasons like the actual pigment used in the paint or its availability and usage. It also may depend on how expensive it costs the Camel company to produce this particular paint. Alright. Then we have a square box. This indicates the opacity of the color. Blank square means transparent. Half filled square indicates that the paint is semi-transparent and full-filled square indicates that the color is opaque, which means this color is capable of covering the underlying color completely. The backside of the tube shows that they are ACMI certified. The AP rating here indicates that this product is considered to be non-toxic by the American Society for Testing and Materials. For us as users of this product, it simply means that these colors are safe to use without any potential hazardous risk. Okay. In some of the tubes, you also have an additional warning which indicates cancer agent by inhalation based on tests with laboratory animals. This actually suggests that we are not supposed to use these pigments for spray painting. One thing you want to note is the difference between 9 ml tubes with the other sizes. If you see closely, they don't have the opacity of the color. Otherwise, all the other size tubes have the same set of information on its outer cover. So that's why I wanted beginners to start with the 20 ml, so that right from the beginning you know the behavior of your paints. But sometimes you just want to try out if acrylics are the right choice for you, right? So in that case, get the 9 ml set, and if you also want the opacity information, you can actually go to Amazon and type in the color name, open the 120 ml individual tube picture, and you will be able to see the opacity information there. You can mark it on your tubes with a permanent marker pen. That's a little workaround for you to have all the information on your tubes as well. So here's a small demo of the paintings done completely using only the Camlin Artist acrylic paints. For the full video of these paintings with instructions, check out the card above. I will also link them in the description box below. Before my final thoughts, I do post video tutorials with detailed product reviews like this one, step-by-step instructional videos and much more on my channel every week. So do subscribe and also click on the bell icon so that you get notifications from YouTube whenever I post a new video. Okay, here are my final thoughts. A disclaimer. In no way this is a sponsored video, and the opinion that I share in this video is completely based on my experience working with these paints. Camlin Artist acrylic paints are easily available, comes in variety of sizes which makes it really very affordable, and a variety of shades to choose from. That is, we have around 60 shades. They have good blending capabilities. They are soft, creamy and vibrant, and ideal for mild texture paintings as well. One more thing to add on, they also have the ideal amount of information on the tube. Most of the basic information that you need even before opening the paint tube is available on the Camlin Artist acrylic paint outer packaging. So I would definitely recommend these paints for any beginner starting with acrylics. One point to note is that these paints are soft, so they might be hard to use for heavy texture effects on your projects. So you might have to add a texture paste like a molding paste or something for heavy impasto techniques. Here is a close-up shot of textures. The top shows the paint directly applied from the tube for mild textures. The center shows paint directly applied from the tube for creating heavy textures, and the last row shows paint used along with a molding paste. You can see the difference clearly, and you can also note the difference in the glossiness too. There are also other brands that are available in the market which I will review in the upcoming videos. So do subscribe and stay connected. I have actually covered all the basic details that you need to know about the Camlin Artist acrylic paints. So go ahead and do try them for yourself. If you like what you saw and if you really got value from this video, do click on the like button and share it with your friends too. Do subscribe and let's stay in touch. Here are some useful videos for you to watch. Have a great week and happy painting.